Ok, bonjour et bienvenue. Welcome, hello and welcome chez Parfum Prononcé. Ok, Perfume Pronounced. I won't get a chance to use much French today, other than maybe giving you the chance to hear somebody actually pronounce eau de parfum the correct way instead of eau de parfum or I think the Brits say parfum. They say that a lot. Okay, yeah, so I am here today to talk to you about something that would probably come as a surprise, and that nobody else that I probably is talking about, and that's Eternity. Okay, Eternity, the Eau de Parfum, the EDP version that came out in probably like 2019 or something like that. Recently, it's a recent one. And yeah, I'll explain why I bid on this when there are 1.5 billion flankers for Eternity, the original Eau de Toilette. There's 1 billion of them. I mean, yeah, they cranked them out. Like, I mean, it's ridiculous. It's obviously a money grab, but like, at the end of the day, they're a business, and they have to sell perfume, and they have to move units, and that's what they do with this. And this, yeah, so there are 1 billion flankers for this. God, I mean, just pick a noun, pick an ethereal noun or something vague, and that's the name of the flanker. Eternity Sun, Eternity Summer, Eternity Fresh, Eternity Aqua, Eternity whatever it happens to be. I don't even know if those are actually names of them, but they probably are. Because I didn't pay attention to them at all, and yeah, at all. So, what made me want to test this one then? Because there are so many of them, why did I end up purchasing this bottle of the Eau de Parfum version of this fragrance? And that is, there was another fragrance that I, for the life of me, I can't remember what it was, but it may have been Profondo Lights. Where I started to notice in that one, and among others, that I was able to recognize and distinguish a good cypress note or something that smelled like cypress. And I loved it. I love that note. I love those kind of fragrances that feature those aromatics, those herbs, rosemary. Not that all of that is in this, but like sage, rosemary, cypress, juniper. Those, I mean, they may be called balsamics or whatever, but yeah, I call them aromatics, and I love this style of perfumery. And the other thing that made me want to buy this was obviously nostalgia. Okay, nostalgia. They go, this is sold, and we'll talk about who is behind, like who they're trying to sell this perfume to. But yeah, it's for my generation. I'm 39 years old. So that means that like probably from like 92 to 2000 was my era of like, yeah, perfumery, I guess. And when I smell things from that era, they're scent memories that are so strong, with those kind of scents that came out at a certain, that they come out at anyone's, a particular time of anyone's life, particularly their youth, that, can have, that can carry some really strong associations and really strong feelings of nostalgia. And this is one of those, this is one of those for me. And obviously it's a Calvin Klein. And during that era, Calvin Klein ruled, right? It was Calvin Klein in terms of designers. Yeah, I mean, and it's obviously it wasn't him, right? I mean, we all know that Calvin Klein probably had nothing to do with it. It was whatever creative team and the perfumers, but that his brand was top of the food chain back then. And there wasn't really a huge niche market. I can't imagine there was, not like there is today, where it's always growing and getting bigger. But back in the day, if you wanted a fragrance, you went to Macy's. Like there was designer fragrances in the 90s-ish, right? That's where you got your frags. So that's another thing, that's another reason why I bought it. Okay, yeah, so who is this being marketed to? There's two groups that they were like, we gotta catch with this, right? It has to be. Well, and then a third one, but that one, whatever. Two main ones, people who grew up in that era and people who perhaps had an association with, I think you'd actually have to be too young to have a father that wore this. You'd have to be too young, I would think, at this point, to have a solid scent memory of your father wearing this particular perfume. I think it's just too recent. But perhaps you had an older brother or somebody that you knew that wore it and you have a good association with it. Or like I said, you came from my era of perfumery and you just want, you want this nostalgia in a bottle, basically, with the added assurance or at least the confidence that, it will perform. It's not a watered down mess. Like perhaps the original EDT is, well, the reformula. I don't know. Maybe it's still Beast Mode. I don't know. But this will get you through the day, 100%. So yeah, I'm in the first group. I bid hard on it. I bought it for, I think, $40. I think you can have this fragrance for $40-ish. I used FragranceNet. There's plenty of other good reputable online retailers for discounted fragrances. Also, I'm sure this is at you know, Ross, TJ Maxx, Kohl's, whatever discounter, right? So yeah, and then and that will actually lead me to the third element of the target audience, I guess. There's people like me. There's the people who perhaps have a chance association with it, nostalgia reasons, and there's the people who just don't know anything and they see Eternity and they recognize the name, right? And they see it at a Ross or one of those stores and they pick it up because it's like super cheap. Those people exist for all of the major designers to various degrees, but certainly for Calvin Klein because he's one that is just, he's gonna show up there. That's the market for him, especially for something like this. So in terms of the difference between this, like the presentation wise, I don't really talk a whole ton about presentation. You just look at the bottle, like I don't need it. This is what it looks like. But the only change that is noticeable is that the juice is a little bit darker. Obviously, I mean, I don't know, I'm not a perfumer, but I would imagine that choice was done for an aesthetic reason other than like, besides, they didn't need to make it green for the formulation. Like they just did that to give you the effect or to give you the impression that it was a longer lasting, you know, more rich, denser scent. And in all honesty, regardless of the intent behind that, it is. It will give you, it has better longevity. It's a deeper, richer scent than the original. So yeah, that's what I smell in it. It's a huge reminder of the original, along with those cypress and those aromatics in it as well. If you like the original and you needed just somebody telling you like, hey, you can buy this and it'll give you, you can wear it and it's not gonna go poof, it's not gonna be gone in an hour, then you should definitely buy this. It's 100% worth the money in my opinion. I'm glad I own it, I'm glad I bought it. I do wear it. Some fragrances I own strictly for nostalgia purposes and I don't even wear them. This is one that I will wear for nostalgia purposes and I'll smell it every now and then. And, you know, obviously I'll wear it throughout the day. I'll wear it to work or whatever. So, if you like perfumes from that era and you want to feel some nostalgia, but also have the assurance that it's going to perform for you and it's not a total piece of junk. I think this is a gem. This is a gem. And it's perfect for the upcoming fall weather, honestly. For some reason, aromatics just, they're good for fall for me. So I can highly recommend that. I apologize if one of my tangents made me forget something. That happens often with me. But in any case, this is a great fragrance. And I can't recommend it enough. And thank you for your time and for your attention. And see you next time. Au revoir.